Scripps Center for Oceans and Human Health is a new center funded jointly by the National Institutes of Health and also by the National Science Foundation. The impact of the Scripps Center for Oceans and Human Health is manyfold, and we see impact as far as increasing public awareness for marine contaminants and how they may impact human life. It involves many investigators here locally in San Diego, primarily at the University of California, San Diego. Many of these investigators will begin to look at sort of how marine chemicals that are in the environment, how they accumulate and are produced and get to the food chain. So this requires many investigators in the UC system who are chemists, biologists, public health, and also medical doctors begin to sort of look at this problem from many different points of view to begin to understand the consequences of these chemicals in the environment and how they impact us.
So my main focus at the Scripps Center for Oceans and Human Health is to try to understand the range of compounds that we find in different organisms in the marine environment, primarily at the top of the food chain, so fish that forage right at the top like tuna and swordfish. And also we look at marine mammals because marine mammals accumulate these compounds over their entire lifetime. So it's a lot easier to actually detect them in those, so that's the first place we look. So we're looking at both the range of compounds that we find in these organisms and then trying to partition them into compounds that we know are made by humans and compounds that we think are natural but potentially have similar toxic impacts as the natural compounds. Our hypothesis is that the natural compounds are being made by organisms that sit very low in the food chain, so single cell organisms that either live in coastal environments or in the open ocean. And as organisms consume these, they sort of pass the compounds along. They're not very easily metabolized or used up by the organism, so it kind of gets stored. And when one organism gets eaten by the organism in the next level of the food chain, it gets passed on essentially. And so that's why organisms right at the top tend to concentrate these compounds. And so because we actually consume, we don't consume dolphins, but we consume tuna and swordfish that sit at the top, they also feed at the same sort of trophic level as these dolphins, there's the possibility that humans will consume these fish and then accumulate those compounds as well. And breast milk in particular is of concern because like the blubber in the dolphins, these compounds will concentrate in breast milk because they have that kind of a chemistry. And so that's one direct way where you can eat seafood. So one of the things that what SDSU, our partners at SDSU will do is actually survey all these women who are pregnant and get a sense of what their food consumption is like. And then we'll pair that with the breast milk samples that we analyze for these particular compounds.
So UC San Diego is a fantastic place to study this problem. We're the only university in the United States that has a major oceanographic institution adjacent to a school of pharmacy as well as to a school of medicine. And myself being a professor both at Scripps as well as the pharmacy school can help bridge that connection between discoveries that are here that are more oceanographic, that are basic science, with more application and human health in the school of pharmacy.